हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एंड यू आर वाचिंग डिंपल पटेल चैनल एंड यू आर हियर फॉर लर्निंग समथिंग न्यू विच आई हैड लर्न फ्रॉम माय एक्सपीरियंस फ्रॉम वेरियस कंपनीज. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय सीरीज फॉर द सिलेनियम विथ सी शार्प और यू कैन से विथ विजुअल स्टूडियो. सो मैनी टाइम्स इट हैपन्स दैट वेन यू आर गूगलिंग समथिंग एंड यू डोंट गेट प्रॉपर ट्यूटोरियल्स. Basically, you want the small examples only, and for that you have to go through the blogs and all that things. So my purpose is that without wasting your much time, I am going to show you the small examples from which you can learn the things very easily. So first of all, let's start with Visual Studio today. So you can download the Visual Studio from the website, and you can have the community version also, which is okay. And after that, we need to install few settings also to create some projects. So please try to download the entire Visual Studio version. It will take some time, but it's okay. So let's start with the Selenium. So in Java, you have seen that we have to add the jar libraries. The same way we have to add here the packages as well. So in Visual Studio, we use packages, nugget packages instead of jar file, which were used in the Java. So I will try to connect all the things with the Java and C sharp as well. So many of the peoples which are coming from the Java background or Selenium Java, and they are converting their career to Selenium C sharp, they can easily do that thing. So let's start by creating a project. So we'll create a unit test project. Let it say unit test 4, and for this we have to install Selenium nugget package, and you have to keep the browser driver downloaded on your system. So go to the solution explorer first of all. So we'll go to the solution explorer. From there you can go to manage nugget packages, and from here you will search the Selenium and you will download this. We require just this one library for the .NET commands to be configured. So we have installed it. That's good. Now we can see whether they are installed or not by writing Selenium WebDriver, iWebDriver. So this is the first difference in C sharp. In Java we used to write WebDriver, and here I have to write iWebDriver. So let's see driver, and you can just import the library. So we have installed it properly. Now we'll use the Chrome browser. You can use the other browser also. So for that we need the Chrome driver. So here it's opening the Chrome driver. So again we will use the import using. So in Java we used to import the things, and in C sharp we have to use the using keyword to use the packages. So that's done, nothing else. So I think many of you can familiarize, the syntax is same. So let's try to navigate to the URL. So navigate here is a method. Go to URL, and you can type here your whatever URL you want to test. So we'll start with the Google only. Sorry dear. So we can start with google.com, and this. Now let's save it and see in the test explorer. Where does the test explorer is? Now let me open that. So it might be this. So we have created a unit test project. So you will see the methods, that is the test method here in the right side. So from there you can directly run your project. So it's one kind of JUnit or test engine that we have seen in Java, where we used to write test at tag to the methods which we want to run. The same way here we have test method attribute, so we can run it and you can see the browser should get open, but we should get some error. Let's see what is that error. So you will know I always used to create the error and then resolve it, so that you people also understand how to resolve the errors and you remember these things frequently. So it's saying that the Chrome driver exe file doesn't exist in the current directory, means we are missing our exe file reference because Chrome driver doesn't know where the exe file is. So my exe file is here, so you can copy the location and you can just paste it here and make sure to remove this error. And you have to give the path till the folder location, not till the exe file, otherwise it will show the error only. So let's run and see whether the Google is getting open or not. Yay! So we have done our first program. You have installed the Selenium, you trigger the website, you open the browser. So you have done very good. So this is the first step of the Selenium. In the next video, we will start inspecting the element and how to use the send keys command. We'll see in the next video. So till then, you can stay tuned to my channel. And parallelly, we are also going to start our APM session. So if you want to learn the APM session, then please click on the I button. So till then, bye bye. And don't forget to hit the red button, like button, and share button. Bye, everyone.